drive as slow as you can. So now we're cruising 80 kilometers per hour here. In the transport industry, you need to get your loads to the destination in time. You cannot really go so slow that you don't make it to the destination.
Of course.
But if we start off the speed impact, so if I now click from 80 kilometers per hour to 81, that's 1 kilometer step.
Yeah.
I start using this amount of more fuel per every 100 kilometers.
Okay.
So
and
it's
that's half a liter.
Half a liter.
Yeah.
So now if I click 9 more times, so I have set speed of 90. Mm. That means 10 bottles like this per every 100 kilometer.
5 liters, a huge difference.
It's a massive difference. So then the $1 million question is that...
It's like 15% there, yeah.
The $1 million question is that how slow can you drive with getting to your destination in time?
Yeah. Because that's priority one. You need to get your cargo to where it needs to be on time,
yeah,
of course.
Yeah. And maybe driving 80 kilometers per hour is not realistic for many of the truck drivers in continental Europe.
Yeah.
But if you drive daytime in Central Europe, quite often you drive in a traffic environment where we are.
Yeah.
But you drive in a queue with a lot of trucks, and in many of the sections of the road you have during daytime overtaking restrictions. So you're forced to go as fast as the queue goes.
Yeah.
And the speed of that queue varies from 65 to 85. That's how fast it goes. So if you try to drive fast, you need to start overtaking, and if there's an overtaking restriction, then you're basically violating the traffic rules.
Yeah.
You can be fined. If you can live with that, then I guess that's what you can do. I cannot recommend it. But then you have this driver who always tries to drive 90, and then you have the driver who just sticks to the queue.
Yeah.
And whenever there is a road construction work or stall, traffic jam, the slower drivers catch the faster up. So in reality, you don't gain as much as you would think with driving 90. And a few summers back, I was driving from southern Germany up to north to Travemünde Harbor.
Yeah.
And I was being in a queue because I don't overtake in those zones where it's forbidden. And the queue goes 65 to 85. Then I can see some busy colleagues overtaking, and then they jump truck at the time forward in the queue.
Yeah.
And then about 15 kilometers to Travemünde, we all met up again. They were on the truck stop, and they went into the tax-free store to buy souvenirs to take home and stuff.
Yeah.
And we all went into the same ferry. And I was driving 65 to 85 and not overtaking anyone. Yeah. So
and then, probably driving in a more relaxed way as well.
Yeah. So we've been evaluating this, and if you drive in Europe during daytime, if you need to drive about 500 to 550 kilometers a day, you should be fine with driving 85 kilometers per hour, because that's the good compromise between, maybe you could go even lower, but at least you shouldn't be going any faster than that.
Yeah.
Then when you start to be in need of reaching 600 to 650 kilometers roughly during daytime in Europe, then you probably need to go a little bit faster to gain some mileage for the day within legal driving time hours.
Yeah.
So let's say that 85 is not enough for me. I click now for 87.
It's
two to three bottles per 100 kilometers more diesel gone. But then maybe I make it to the destination. Then we have these operations where you need to go 700 kilometers or more. And first of all, might be unrealistic to achieve that amount of kilometers during daytime in Europe, because the traffic environment is has so heavy traffic. So those operations where truck needs to go 700 to 800 kilometers during one mission or shift, it's probably nighttime traffic. Has to be. So during daytime you don't gain anything with driving 88 to 90 kilometers per hour. During nighttime you might gain some, but then you need to take into account that increasing the speed again from 85 to 90, then it's five of these bottles for every 100 kilometers. So you need to be able to invoice that to your customers to still keep it profitable business.
Yeah.
So yeah, drive as slow as you can to make it to the destination, but very rarely during daytime in Europe you gain anything by driving faster than 84 to 85.
Yeah. And in the end it's the driver decision, but like you say, they need to have a profitable business. So as long as they make a decision that is based on an argument and a reasoning behind it, that choice is valid.
Yeah.
If they consume more, then fine, if that's necessary to get the job done.
Yeah.
As long as they get paid for it.
And I would say that if within one shift of driving you need to reach more than 700 kilometers, then you need to start really considering driving faster than 85. That's a good rule of thumb.
Yeah.
So, drive as slow as you can with still making it in time to the destination, and that's how you minimize the air drag.
Yeah.
And then
that's a good summary.
Yeah. And then keep your Michelin men inside the cab.
Yeah, preferably.
Yeah. Cool. See you next time.